But for my muffin.
Greetings, I'm Rob Chappers.
I'm the captain.
We're back after a dirty, filthy breakfast covered in gravy and
lunches. I tell you, it was dirty.
And
we had a huge political debate for some reason at lunchtime.
Well, I didn't. You were being a dibble. I slightly fell asleep.
It was bizarre. Anyway, so the Tube Screamer, much loved, iconic. I'll just spray that again. A much loved and iconic drive pedal. You know, referred to, I believe, I forget whether it was Guitarist Magazine or the American version of that, that just said two words, the best.
No, it was Yoda who said that.
It might have been.
He best looked. The.
Or perhaps it was Chewbacca who just went.
That's absolutely what Chewbacca was. But just to correct you, that isn't actually Chewbacca.
This isn't Chewbacca.
No, that's just one of his fellow
I agree. This is just a random Wookiee extra.
Yes.
So, the Tube Screamer, you know, has had many variants over the years. You've got the TS808, the TS9. You've had many companies doing copies of them. You've even had companies like Keeley who physically take original ones and just modify them. Although, interestingly, no longer do that. So, the big one of the big exciting announcements, or not big really, it's very small announcements that was made at the 2015 Winter NAMM show was of the a genuine Ibanez Mini Tube Screamer.
Yeah.
It's this one over here, which as you can see to scale is nearly twice the size
it's
of
It's twice
Yoda.
As big as Yoda, so you know, you're getting a lot of bang for the buck.
Hang on.
Raise the Tube Screamer I will.
That is about as good as the effects will probably be on the new Star Wars film. In fact, they should just hire Lee to do that.
So what we thought we'd do is, do they actually sound any different or better or whatever than the bigger ones?
Oh, I'm sure they'll sound better because it's smaller.
Now, the Mini Tube Screamer is supposed to have a chip that is based on the TS9. So really, the kind of the shootout, if you like, is between these ones. But because we had a TS808 here, and it's so iconic, we thought, why not do all of them?
Is there anything different other than the fact that it's smaller?
Well, I'm guessing it physically has smaller guts. I don't know if it has an identical chip or just a chip based on the TS9. But you know what? We could talk spec forever.
So the cows physically return to their
homestead.
What's the
only thing that's actually important?
Is the sound.
Is the sound.
Here's this one then.
So what do you want to start with? This one?
Central,
or this one?
Central. All of them central.
All of them literally
and we'll
at
just,
12
we'll get
o'clock.
ABC.
Okay. So we're at 12 o'clock on all of them. Let's have the reference tone then. Pay attention, Yoda. You're not sitting there.
Yeah,
right
Yoda.
Now. Hang on, he's dropped his...
Get it right.
So we'll start with the 808 then, shall we? Here we go.
Sounds the best. That one sounds the best.
You think so?
I think it's got a rawer, kind of a slightly growlier quality to it.
I was simply thinking as you went through them how all three sounded different.
They do, yeah, they do sound different.
You know, and therefore, you know, very much down to the guitar and the amp and the player as to choose whichever one they think
this
they
has
like
a bit
the
a
best.
Touch more gain, just a touch.
Well, why don't we start doing? Let's twiddle around. Twiddle around. So, let's talk about kind of the basis of the Tube Screamer. It is a, what would you call it? It's a sort of a light, drivey, boosty kind of.
It's got a Bespin-y. It's that kind of cloudy Bespin-y type.
Bespin-y. I'm sorry.
Yeah, Bespin, kind of cloudy, kind of light, kind of Cloud City, and that bus drives by.
Sorry.
Kind of a soft ethereal kind of tone to it. Not like kind of Tatooine-ish.
I see.
Kind of full out, kind of grainy.
And what's this one more sort of Death Star? Is it sort of more just, you know, metallic?
That's more Hoth,
icy
kind of.
Icy.
Yeah.
Sorry. I see. What's he talking about? Bespin?
Bespin's the Cloud City.
I don't remember that at all.
What year were you born?
72.
Traitor!
So, sorry. Let me just get my brain in gear. Who lived in the Cloud City? Was that Lando Calrissian?
Yes, the best character from Star Wars ever.
He was the best character from Star Wars. But he lived in a cloud. See, I'm thinking, when you say Cloud City, I'm thinking Flash Gordon.
With the old
Brian Blessed. Hawkman died! What were they called Hawkman?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was an amazing
the best
impression.
Line of any film
and
ever.
And he is one of the best
Gordon's
actors.
Gordon's alive!
Gordon's alive! Yeah, he is one of the best characters ever.
So,
but yeah, Bespin, B-Wings,
back to Star Wars,
Lando Calrissian, and so cloudy, light, yeah. Airy tones, Tatooine, the sand planet, you know, the dunes, Jabba the Hutt.
I've got that. That's a really good impression.
Well, I try to watch a lot of Star Wars.
So anyway, so the idea was that I think the Tube Screamer was born in an era where guitar players had guitar amplifiers and they just thought, I just need to push this a bit more. So it was like some of the more vintage Marshalls.
Unusual for guitar players to say
that,
really.
It's like, I need to cook this amplifier a bit more. And I think also as well, the Tube Screamer had an army of fans from lots of guitar players who would go, look, I'm turning up at venues, I've got a hired-in backline rig, and I just need a pedal that I can plug in, and I know I'm going to get sort of something like my signature sort of sound. And so the Tube Screamer absolutely isn't one of these kind of very heavy kind of, you know, drive pedals where you turn the pedal on and
yes,
it just makes you sound like that pedal.
It's the cream on top of the cake. You get a really yes. heavy driven amp and then
I like
you
that
work
analogy.
Out. Yeah, and then you add that on top and it's just enough to give you lead.
So very much so that, you know, that you've got to have the right kind of guitar and amp kind of setup already for a Tube Screamer to kind of work. But like I said, I've used Tube Screamers actually in all sorts of amps, even relatively inexpensive solid state amps, and
yeah.
I've still had
well,
a decent...
Well, we're using a stacked single coil here, so it's just a bit hotter than a single coil.
And a bit darker than a
single coil. And a little bit darker, so it's not quite a humbucker, but still it's beef.
It's a hum-cancelling
yes.
Tele bridge pickup. So as the main focus of this video is the Diddy one, let's see what it sounds like as we go through. Can I just say as well, I don't want to be critical of Ibanez, but I'm going to be critical of Ibanez. Could you please make all of your LED lights a bit brighter on your pedals? It's really quite...
Oh yeah, that's not
perhaps
really...
Perhaps if it was dark in here, it would be
that's
easier.
That's not rock box quality, is it?
Are they particularly bright
well, yeah.
LEDs, are they? I don't
yeah,
remember.
It's like
they.
Blinding.
Blinded.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's just start with the basic sound. Here it is.
It's just a bit warmer, isn't it? That would sound nice, wouldn't it? Did you hear what was going to happen there?
Feedback.
Just a tiny, tiny bit of back.
Keep going. About this pedal is actually the overdrive button isn't really driving the knob isn't really driving the amp any harder. It's clearly the level control that's probably going to drive the amp harder. So let's
yeah.
see if we can sort of combine a bit of driving the amp harder with some drive from the pedal.
Yeah.
good. That's I'm just going to try and do some similar tones out of this one. See how close. Drive in it.
It's. I'm not really sure if it's got more drive.
If I turn them both up max.
So do that one, then add that one. Yeah, that one first. Oh, really? Yeah, it's thicker. That's a little bit thicker drive. That's a bit crunchier.
Yeah, I think that's darker as well.
Yeah, it is darker for sure.
Which I prefer it with a little bit more brightness in there. This is sort of. Try that again.
Did it I mean, for my money, that sounds a lot nicer.
Yeah, I say a lot nicer. Well, I mean,
it's a personal preferential thing. I prefer the tone of this, but this sounds Marshall-ish. Kind of like crunchy.
I think they're
more of a kind of, you get your rhythm sound, but then you get a different kind of rhythm sound that could be a lead tone. Like, what I want to do really is drive this, and then put that on top.
Let me just, I'm just going to max out the gain, because I think it's quite interesting, as in which one of these pedals has kind of got the most gain in it, just for people to sort of see. And I'd like to hear it before we jump over to a gainy sound. I'd like to hear it on a guitar.
Not
with
gainy, just crunchy.
Can we hear it with either the brown one or the gold one, maybe? Or?
Okay.
So anyway, so here's this one, the TS808. Good sounding pedals. I actually like that one.
Yeah, that does sound great gunned.
It's had some sort of nice harmonic.
But that's got a little bit of low end that comes in that the other one hasn't got. They are very different.
What do you think the Ewok thinks?
I think he thinks, oh, teeny! I know, that wouldn't be an Ewok though.
Wouldn't it sound like an Ewok?
What would it be, Lee?
I don't know, sorry.
Oh, Lee. Hang your head, for shame,
Star
Lee.
Wars fail.
It would be a Jawa.
Oh, yes, with the little red eyes and the brown.
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely. So I thought Ewok did sound much
like
a Jawa.
And who would this be?
That's the Emperor.
What's his name? It's like he's giving offering a drink.
Shaking my hand. Yeah. Is he skiing? Hang on, he's not. He's skiing.
It looks like he's feeding the pony with that one.
Oh, he is. Here you go, pony.
have some food.
Here we go.
If you're a pony.
Right.
I'll give you a clue. His name begins with P.
Peter.
Yes. It's Emperor Peter.
What was his name?
Palpatine.
Emperor Palpatine. Yes, I remember. Well, I would never have got that.
And what's his name, Lee?
Kevin.
Yes. Correct.
Okay. So
let's
what did
just
you
push,
do? Push,
I'll push
the amp a bit more.
Just a little bit.
Push the amp a bit more.
Bit dry.
So how did an Ewok sound? You didn't tell me in the end. And then when one of their friends dies, it's like,
why would you do an impression of a dying Ewok?
Do you remember that bit, like where he just sort of goes,
yeah.
He's clearly can't move in his suit, so he just sort of goes, I'll see if I can do it on here. Here's an Ewok dying. Hang on. That was it.
That's really sad.
Seriously, Lucas is going to be watching this going, how am I going to top these special effects in my new film?
Yeah, maybe I'll bring out another film.
I've got no chance.
And take liberties with the storyline. Anywho, I'll just increase the drive just a little bit.
Okay, and what I'll do is I'll back the drive off on the pedals.
Yeah, here's the reference tone. Too much reverb.
A bit less reverb. drive is the one that says gain on it, so not the one that says drive.
Yeah, that confused the crap out of me.
Exactly, that's what I was saying before.
Now that's where, this is the kind of setting I'd use a tube screamer with.
Yeah, so you've got rhythm tone.
If you back it off, bring it in, you got your sort of, you know, rhythm. Step on one of these. Yeah, that wasn't doing it for me.
Really?
Nah, middle one. Yeah, I feel like that adds to the tone. I feel like it complements the warmth. And what about the last one? That's nice. It's a nice tone. I prefer this one, hands down.
Yeah, I like
but
this one.
I don't mind that, but I much prefer this over that.
Interesting. You see, I wonder if it's clever people at Ibanez that go, let's not make a cheaper pedal that sounds better than one of our dearer pedals, but let's make them all sound good.
That's a conspiracy theory.
Progressive.
That's the first time I've ever heard you come up with a conspiracy theory. But I mean, isn't it great that the classic, you know, would sound?
I just quickly do. In fact, can you get a humbucker loaded guitar, please?
Yeah, man.
What would you prefer, the gold one or the brown one?
Yeah. I'll take the.
I take gold.
Yeah, so gold.
Always believe in your soul. You got the power to know you're indestructible. Always believe in. I say gold.
Gold.
So let's just do the same as what we did before, which is,
okay,
you know, jang 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 without. Then I kick it in. Next pedal.
All right.
The tube scream.
Let's do that. I was just going to suggest we did all of them.
It's quite noisy.
It's like the seaside. That's quite nice.
I can hear
there's
the
a wave
sea.
Coming. It comes another wave.
Tsunami!
That's a really pleasant, relaxing sound. I'm a truth speaker, soothsayer, hair farmer.
And
I prefer this one, hands down. But this is a great, great pedal.
I think what's nice is that they're all clearly doing a tube screamer thing. And whether you've got, you know, £65 on this side or £150 on this side or... I think he's about 110, I think. You know, you can now own a genuine Ibanez tube screamer, and if you know, and hopefully this video has demonstrated the small tonal differences between.
But they're also all made in Japan.
Really?
Yes.
I say, really?
Yeah.
Well, even that one.
Yes.
Is that what it says underneath? Made
how much
in Japan?
Is this worth?
£65.
How much is that?
£109.
Well, you'd expect there to be a difference, wouldn't you?
Well, it's twice the size, you know. So
it is
clearly,
twice the size. So yeah. But here's the question. Would you get that or would you get one of its competitors? For example, recently we did some amazing little pedals that I would argue would comparatively, in my opinion, win out over this.
Well, I think there's the pedal market now is so saturated with choice. I mean, they're just Andertons, and I reckon we sell all the big brands and a good few of the small brands. But we probably, there's still dozens of brands that we don't stock. And if you said to me, can I come to Andertons tomorrow and try some drive pedals, please? There would be at least 150 different pedals to try.
That's great.
So no one...
If you want a day out, go to McDonald's, grab yourself a nice takeaway.
Do not come and ask to try 150 drive pedals.
Are you saying people can't go to your store and try 150
But this is the problem, isn't
it? Why don't you have a pedal board set up with 150?
With 150. Can you imagine...
And then all patched in. Then you walk in with your guitar, plug in, you go, right, one...
Not a bad idea.
Two, three...
You'd never remember what the first one sounded like by the time you got to like the fourth
or
the
fifth one. Have a little bingo scorecard.
I think what most people do with pedals now is they do simply sort of go,
I want a green one.
Choose a price bracket that I can kind of afford and then, you know, try some pedals that maybe the salesman recommends or I've read about or whatever. But there's so much choice. And I think where the Tube Screamer is going to be popular is with people that just go, do you know what? I haven't got the time or the will to watch 50 YouTube videos or try 50 distortion pedals in Andertons. I just know that I want a Tube Screamer sound, and I know I want to spend £65, and I know it to go on a small board because I've only got a small amount of space. And I think that's where this will win, because it's got that family heritage name. Who else have we got here? Jeez, have you seen the size of this one? Look at that. He's got like a special warrior armband.
Yeah, he has a special warrior armband and massive forearms.
Look at the grip action there.
Do you mind if I just put the ghost fret through it to see what the low sounds are like?
What, can he put the ghost fret through it?
Also, and I'm just saying this, you know, you might want to consider contacting them to do some of the voiceovers. Because clearly it's a waste of talent. You've already wiggled your hand in a phone shape.
If you're interested, by the way, we're using a Sir Badger as our guitar amp.
Great amp, really nice. Yeah, love it.
I was going to say, where did that bass come from? But you're using bass...
Yeah.
You're very low, aren't you?
No, I use 11 to 60s. Like, it's just... And the drive is barely half the way up.
Just a little bit. I don't know, I've got like the Tin Man from The Wizard of Oz here.
No, it's not. It's not the Tin Man from The Wizard of Oz. Lee, it's not the Tin Man from The Wizard of Oz.
Who is it then?
It's one of Boba Fett's assassin crew from the Empire Strikes Back, the best of the three films. You know, the dark is... Really nice.
Let's just get some good sounds from this little one.
Interesting.
What was it doing? Some sort of double tracked chorusy sort of thing?
No, I think I much prefer it when the guitar's tuned lower than I did when it was. It's. I like it more for the lower tuned tone than I did for the higher tuned tone. Can I just? brutal for rhythm playing.
They're very different when you switch and you keep going back and forth, and each time it highlights almost like more difference.
Yeah, but this is great for kind of brutal rhythm playing. Like, it's got that kind of crunchy rhythmic. That's way more of a lead pedal as well. But let's try this one. See, now I'm a little bit confused, because don't like that one.
That was my favourite one earlier in the demo.
It removes some tone that I like from the
album. Removes some gain, I think.
I love for the heavier rhythm phrasing and some of the lead playing. This is still my favourite.
Shall I play something?
Yes.
What are we on?
We're on the little one, halfway.
Okay, just put everything. What? How much gain have I got on the amp? Perhaps I've got too much gain.
I'll turn the gain off now.
Look at what would happen if a Ewok and a Wookiee had a baby. Would they have an Ewookie?
So a Wookiee and an Ewok. They'd have a Weewok.
Right, Weewok. I'm going to play, and you're going to fiddle with the pedals like a professional.
Sound we've had all day.
It's good. Which one's that?
That's these two.
Oh, the two together.
Now, here's the interesting thing. For me, this is a great lead sound, and for me, this is a great rhythm sound. Now, that's interesting.
So what we're saying is you need both.
What I'm saying, like, I'm do. That this is your rhythm sound.
Yeah.
So here's your like As
I'm,
you clean.
I'm back on, so I'm on a single coil setting.
Like, they're a brilliant team.
Well, we spent far too long now just talking about little pedals, so I think we should...
But that's what we love doing, and people love to watch us talk complete rubbish about pedals.
So, say bye, Chewy.
The thing is, and this is off camera, because... Oh, he just died.
Who did?
The Ewok just jumped off the side. Oh. This is giving you the kind of rhythm tone that you need. Like, it's occupying that part of the spectrum, and this is occupying part of the lead spectrum, and if you marry them, you get that thick, great tone that you need.
I do like, I must admit, it's kind of like, I go through my entire guitar playing life going, here's the product that was originally designed to do this, Strat, Les Paul, Marshall, Tube Screamer,
yes,
whatever, going, but I'll just go and find something that allegedly does it better.
But here I go, and it won't.
And then eventually you just end up going, yeah, it's pretty good actually, the first one, wasn't
it? When they got it right, they got it right.
Yeah.
But that works. They work great.
They work great.
They should bring out the two together.
I totally agree. Anyway, right, we better get on. It's all British.